السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. I don't have a speech. I'll speak from my heart, inshallah. First and foremost, after thanking Allah Azza wa Jal who made all of this possible, I really want to say Jazakum Allah Khairan to the Shaykh, and that doesn't do justice to what all you have done and all your sacrifices, and may Allah bless your wives and your children. I know I brought my family here, so may Allah bless them for your allowing us to teach us. And I never dreamed a day like this would come. And Jazakum Allah Khairan for imparting on us knowledge, but distilling from the classical teachings of the Quran and Sunnah and the classical texts in a way that has made Islam relevant for me in this life and practical in living in North America. That's something that I grew up. I'm one of the first generation. I grew up in the 70s, and I quote Dr. Qadhi's comments that we had our masajids in apartments, and the musalla was the living room, and we didn't have much. And so I wanted to say Jazakallah Khairan for that. I also want to thank Al Maghrib volunteers for all they've done. And indeed, I want to thank Al Maghrib for bringing my family together. Many of the classes I took was with my brother Jamil, who's here, and my mother, that brought me closer to them. So Jazakallah Khairan for that. And I sincerely want to thank my mom, Noor Jahan Sharif, for raising me for what I am today. And with the little limited resources she had in the 70s and 80s, after and my dad, who's not here, may Allah bless both of them and give them sadaqah jariyah immensely for what they have done. And I want to thank my wife, who's made it easy for me to travel for all of these classes and watch the home, because I know many wives wouldn't put up with their husbands being gone for many weekends. And it's been like that for the last 8 years. So may Allah give her the ajr for that. And to my abandoned children, Salma, Amin, and Hadia, and my sons, Salim, and Abdullah, and Umar, Salim, and Musa, I want to... my brothers here, I want to thank them and then make them realize that age has no limit to seeking knowledge, whether young or old. And that's what I want them to realize. I want them to appreciate and value what they have that I didn't have. And I also want them to realize that that you can do it. Don't let any of these excuses stop you from seeking knowledge. And I hope I'm an inspiration for you, that when you'll be standing here on stage from the Al-Maghrib Institute Jamia, inshallah, when it opens up, that you'll be here giving the speech. And I also want to echo the words of Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who said that the deeds most beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are the deeds that are done regularly, even if they are small. So even though I may be a professional working 12 to 14 hours a day, and I'm never around, realize that if you put an effort to it, and hopefully I'm a living example after 8 years, even being a physician, that I can achieve that goal, that as Al-Muhammad al-Sharif said, give your excuses a black eye. Wallahi, stop making excuses for the shaitan. I'm too old. I hear some uncles tell me, I'm too old. Nonsense. I hope I learn till I die. So don't have that attitude. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of you and increase you all in knowledge. And this again, this is a milestone, this is not an end. And I hope that we will continue to achieve more milestones that will benefit this community we live in. Jazakum Allah khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.